Hello, my golfing store golfers, Matt Bradbury here. Discuss another useful tool for this training aid, bunker shots. Real simple, there's a lot of hinge in a bunker shot. So a lot of folks get too wristy, and I'm gonna just turn my wrist here for this, but a lot of folks pick that club up too vertical, they get too much hand action. So again, this will help eliminate some of that hand action for those wristy players, or those folks that don't have enough, they're too stiff wristed during these bunker shots. This will really help them find the correct angle here. So what we're looking for is that face to be slightly open to the target. And when we open that face, we're gonna align our bodies just slightly left here. This is a long bunker shot, so I'm gonna try to hit a little closer to the ball. And as I'm making this golf swing, I'm really looking for a good arm swing, good chest movement going back. Feel that connection between the training aid and my left forearm, and retain that angle as I go through the strike here. That was pretty good execution of it. So again, I felt the pressure, so I know I got good wrist set. Then I drove down and let that club splash the sand. Really focus on splashing the sand. This really helps too if you cup through the bunker, which is okay to release the golf club in a bunker because it activates the back of the club, the flange of the club. It eliminates the digging motion. So again, hinge and then release it. Release that line there, and that's gonna help you activate that flange. It's okay to cup it in a bunker. So again, just a lot of cup action, a lot of hand action, and that's gonna help get that ball out and hopefully on the green and make more par safes.